Here is a view of Xcode, showing our pitch-perfect apt. I'm going to go over some of the basic parts of Xcode, and we'll be diving into the code in just a moment. On the left side, you can see the Navigator panels, starting with the Project Navigator. On the middle is the content area, and it's currently showing the settings for our pitch-perfect project. On the right side, you have the utility area with the inspector panels, with the file inspector panel currently open. On the bottom, you can see the debug and console windows. Unlike other IDEs and editors you may have used in the past, Xcode requires only a single click to select a file or an item. Starting with the Navigator panel on the left, there are many different ways to view the files and other parts of your project. There are even ways to move through these panels with just a keyboard. As an example, you can use Command 0 to toggle the Navigators panel on and off, if, like me, you need to find more screen space from time to time. On the right side, we have the Inspectors panel, and the number available depends on the content or item you have selected. In the case of this project setting, we can see File and Quick Help inspectors. As you progress with your app, you'll be able to see other inspectors. Much like the Navigator panels, you can toggle the inspector panels by using keyboard shortcuts to move through them. This is especially useful if you're in need of more space to view your content. At Udacity, we have a saying that content is king. And with Xcode, that is also true. The code and even your user interface in storyboards are always in the center view, here in the prime spot in the content editor. On the bottom right, we have the library, and at the very bottom of the screen, you can see the debug and console panels. The console panel is where you see the Hello World printed. The Xcode Content Editor is where you're going to spend a lot of your time as an iOS developer. It can adapt to help you edit any part of your project, from project settings, to code, to user interface elements. Knowing that the editor is context sensitive can help a lot when you're looking for how to change a particular setting in Xcode. With the Pitch Perfect project, which is the little blue icon here on the top of the Project Navigator, we can see the settings for the entire project. We can see the version that iOS is targeting, and we can see that the interface file is called main, for main storyboard. We can also use this to decide what orientations to support and to launch in. Here you can see we're supporting the portrait orientation, as well as landscape left and landscape right. If we select the AppDelegate Swift file, we can see that the Xcode Editor panel changes to let us modify the Swift source code. You can see that Xcode automatically highlights the code to make it easier to read. Remember that main storyboard selection back in the project settings? That's referring to this file, main.storyboard. If you select it in the Project Navigator with a single click, the Xcode Editor changes to show you the user interface for this application. You can use two-finger pinch to zoom out of it so you can see the entire thing. This is the view we're going to use to set up any UI elements for our iOS apps, including Pitch Perfect. I know it may seem like a lot, but we'll walk you through step by step and touch every part of Xcode by the time you've completed this course.